Believe me, Doctor. Chairman Koval is not someone we want to see at the Praetor's right hand. I'll have Sloan confined to his quarters immediately, but that may not solve our problem.
So?
Has it occurred to you that you and Sloan may not be the only ones here working for Section 31? For all we know, he has a confederate somewhere in the delegation.
Well, Sloan did say that our mission would be strictly reconnaissance, that we wouldn't be called upon to do anything else. That could suggest another operative, someone whose mission isn't limited to reconnaissance.
If that's true, it could be anyone. Even a member of the Bellerophon crew.
Or a Romulan.
What?
Sir, I believe Sloan has an accomplice here. On Romulus.
What makes you say that?
Two things. First, Sloan has too much information on the inner workings of their government, too many insights into their political process. Second, Sloan's plan is to kill Koval while making it appear to be an accelerated case of Tuvan syndrome. Now, the only way to do that would be to expose Koval to a short burst of Nadion radiation. The simplest plan would be to maneuver him near a phaser relay and surreptitiously irradiate him. Now, since I doubt very much that Sloan is going to have the chance to do that, it stands to reason someone else is going to have to.
A Romulan.
Exactly. Sir, Sloan may have already gotten things underway. We have to warn them.
And how am I supposed to explain Section 31 to the Romulans? All hell would break loose if they hear that there's a rogue Federation agency running around plotting assassinations. Could bring the Alliance down. Besides, all we have is speculation at this point.
Admiral.
The answer is no. After I have Sloan arrested, I'll break radio silence and inform Starfleet Command of the situation. Your orders are to sit tight and do nothing until you hear from me.
Aye, sir.
Said she went in to deliver a report, found him slumped over his desk.
Do they have any idea what happened?
Dr. Frame said it looked like an aneurysm, but they're still running tests.
An aneurysm? I saw the Admiral this morning. He looked fine.
They say that's the way it happened.
Which Admiral are you talking about?
Admiral Ross, sir. He collapsed at his desk.
Where is he?
Sick bay.
I can't trust anybody aboard the Bellerophon, and I can't contact DS9. For security reasons, there's been a communications blackout. Senator, I have no one else to turn to. I need your help.
To do what?
I have reason to believe that Sloan has an accomplice within the Romulan government. Someone who's going to help him carry out this assassination.
Koval has been saying there's a traitor in the Senate. Someone working for Starfleet Intelligence?
Section 31 isn't part of Starfleet Intelligence.
They are Federation citizens working to advance your interests. That makes them your responsibility.
You're absolutely right. That's why I'm doing everything I can to stop them. I'm trying to convince Sloan that Koval doesn't have Tuvan syndrome, but he may have already asked his accomplice to proceed. So if we want to be sure to stop this assassination, we have to find Sloan's Romulan accomplice.
And you expect me to find this traitor?
Sloan said something about Koval having a personal database. It stands to reason that it contains a list of potential suspects. Now, is there any possible way you can get me a copy of this database so that I can run an analysis of
the... You are asking me to hand over secret documents.
I'm asking you to put aside 3 centuries of mistrust between our peoples and help me stop a murder. Senator, if we can't reach out and bridge the gulf that is between us, if we can't trust each other, a man will die and we will be partially responsible. I need your help. Please.
You wanted to see me, Doctor?
Yes. I'm not convinced that Koval is suffering from Tuvan syndrome. His symptoms could be the result of any number of different health problems.
You didn't say that before.
I'm not an expert on Romulan physiology. Most of my knowledge on Tuvan syndrome comes from studies done on Vulcan patients.
I thought Vulcans and Romulans were virtually identical.
Yes, but there are some important genetic differences.